我们的比较教育学者，年轻的学者呢，我觉得缺乏对中国本身的过程的了解，所以我寄希望于他们呢，就是还是不能脱离中国的世界。
I would say, if you are cynical about life, don't even come to this. People who come to this field are people who have hope, and they believe that they could make a contribution.
一个建议呢，就是对比较教育学科要有一个信念。第二呢，这个我觉得呢，我们研究比较教育呢，这个需要这个有几个基本的这个知识的基础。一个呢，要能够精通一门外语。那么再一个呢，这个我觉得要有一门社会科学的基础。
I've always found the fact that I had a discipline-based PhD was an advantage in getting work. I would say.Get a discipline-based PhD first. Political science, economics, anthropology, sociology, whatever.
Know the field before you do anything. Know the field itself. Know why it's oriented the way it's oriented before you delve into the practical issues that you're certainly going to be faced with eventually.
那比较教育学，对吧？它的自己的概念体系。他的自己的方法论，他自己的研究方法，啊，都需要进一步的来完善。那我们也希望有更多的年轻人，啊，来从事这方面的工作，啊，那么我希望就是我们比较教育学科的研究者，未来研究者，能够通过自己的研究，啊，提出某种思想、某种理论、某种概念，啊，也为这个教育学科中。发展做出理论上的贡献。
I guess my first piece of advice is not about the field per se, but to follow passionately your research interests, because that is what is going to guide you.
I think that's one of the great things about the field, that it is interdisciplinary, and depending on where you're coming from and what your passion is, you can find space to do all sorts of interesting things.
To be honest, to be open-minded, to be ready to change their views when they see the realities, not to be always with the same ideas, to listen to the other guys and have honest intellectual exchange.